The news out of Paris on the condition of Princess Diana is not good. She is now officially reported as dead.
The day Princess Diana died is one of those moments that everyone can remember where they was. It's because people almost feel like they're related to Princess Diana. But it was really as though a family member had passed away. And that's how I still feel, you know? I still feel a sense of grief over Princess Diana passing away because I feel like she had and has something to do with me and something to do with all people of this country.
I believe that I have a stronger connection to the royal family than some others, and the fact that I've met some members of the royal family and even spoken to Prince William about wearing the same tie as he has and him laughing about it made me feel that I had a connection to him. And because they've become so familiar, they're like an extension of my family.
I was at St Andrew's Cathedral, which was fantastic, and so when they arrived, there was just this enormous buzz throughout the cathedral, and they sort of came down the aisle and everyone was craning their necks, and I was just one of those people craning my neck. Kate kind of looked over and gave us a bit of a wave and kind of melted a little bit, but it's okay. I was starstruck. I don't mind admitting it. It's true.
The first time I could vote was the Republican referendum in 1999, and I felt that it was very important that I look at both sides.
I was in primary school at the time, so pretty young, and I couldn't vote.
Most of my friends in year 12 thought it was a little bit odd. They hadn't been interested in politics or the Australian Constitution at all.
And I actually remember going into the school hall and teachers dividing us up, the pupils, into who's going to vote if you could vote for a republic and who's going to vote for the monarchy. And so I actually, even all the way back then, went to the side that was supporting the constitutional monarchy.
It was always a point of contention around the dinner table. We did debate it, and my parents always found it just perplexing and almost amusing that I had taken this stand that they really associated with a bygone era.
Edmondson,
of course. Thank you, please go through. Well, thank you, please go through.
A stereotype of monarchist is that they are white, male and upper class. I don't think that is so. On Twitter recently I was described as a snob because of the fact I was a monarchist, and I found that quite perplexing.
I don't think it's true that monarchists are more likely to be elitist or snobby, and I really haven't found it. And it's something that we actually laugh about, because we can laugh at ourselves, and I think that's important.
It's a great honour and joy to be here with dear friends, dear constitutional monarchist friends. It's an honour to have to one side a larger-than-life portrait of Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, Queen of Australia. And long may she continue to reign, this marvellous monarch, this Queen of Australia.
I suppose I'm rare among the Monarchist League in that I joined when I was 14 years old. I would get sent these bulky envelopes every month called the Liberty Newsletter. And I remember the first time it arrived, I had signed up on the internet without telling my parents. They said, "Why is this sort of weird, kooky group sending you material?" I said, "Oh, I've signed up on the internet, I'm a monarchist now, and you'll just have to deal with it."
A core belief of why I'm a monarchist is that it makes sense that you should have an impartial, apolitical umpire on our system. So if we were to become a republic, there's all manner of questions that, to my mind, could cause enormous political upheaval, which would ultimately harm ordinary Australians. Like, what would be the role between the president and the prime minister? It's a system of government that doesn't work very well.
Maybe we should have a monarchist karaoke.
We could sing songs by Dolly Parton, Queen of Country.
I believe there is always a current threat to the system. There are always people that want to change a system. And just because there is no referendum coming up about the Australian monarchy and a republic, doesn't mean that we should rest and not be concerned about that change.
Oh, did he?
Well, that was a bit of a shock.
Oh, no.
We have seen many, many, many young Australians join the Australian Monarchist League. And really since 2011, when the royal wedding happened, we've seen a really uptake in the amount of younger people joining the Australian Monarchist League. In fact, half of our membership is actually under the age of 35. So it's really blowing out of the water any idea that monarchists are old people.
I have a number of items of memorabilia about the royal family. Most are given to me as presents. A friend of mine that came back from London and she brought a solar-powered waving queen that when the sun hits her handbag, she waves. I've received cups and saucers and even portraits of the queen. I have portraits of the queen around my house. For me, it's a reminder of a system that I believe in, something that's stable. No matter what's happening in my life, there is a stable system governing this country, and I appreciate that.
Additional topless snapshots of Kate, the Duchess of Cambridge, made their way onto magazine covers.
I don't really think the royal family should be gossiped about in the same way you'd gossip about Kim Kardashian. You don't gossip about your cousin. Oh, well, you shouldn't. You keep up with your cousin and you respect them. And that's what it should be about. For example, when the Duchess of Cambridge had those photographs taken of her when she was undressed, like, I would never want to see that. And I don't think anyone should want to see that because I respect her as, you know, the Duchess.
I've received comments such as, oh, don't you believe in Australia? And the thing is, I do believe in Australia. I am Australian. I love Australia. And I find it quite odd that I'm called un-Australian because of these beliefs.
Australia is a 40,000-year-old continent. Indigenous people in this country have been around for 40,000 years. There is no conflict whatsoever in my mind between us being a constitutional monarchy and us recognising our Indigenous peoples.
And if Indigenous people my age feel that the royal family or the system of monarchy that we have is connected to crimes that they feel have been perpetrated against their people, then I think that's fair enough. But I think that you would have to ask them.
I don't think that separating from the monarchy will help Indigenous affairs at all. In fact, I think it would hinder it.
I've had some people say that I shouldn't spend so much time on a cause that they don't see as having to do with, I don't know, charity or social justice. So that it's sort of like, you have such a limited amount of time, why would you spend your time on this issue? You know, shouldn't you be, you know, advocating for a cure for cancer or something? It's always most important to be on your guard when you feel like, okay, the threat's passed. It's when you feel like the threat's passed and when you get complacent that things creep up behind the scenes and then suddenly you've got a Republican threat on your hands.
The Queen.
The Queen.
God bless her.